The night of June 9th, 1912, the town had a Children's Day service, which was sort of an end-of-Sunday school event.
Josiah and Sarah Moore, along with their four children, Herman, Catherine, Boyd, and Paul, attended the program. So did sisters Lena and Ina Stillinger, Catherine Moore's friends.
Church service got out late, about 9:30 at night. The Stillinger girls were to stay with their grandma, but she lived on the opposite end of town, and the streetlights had been shut off.
But Catherine asked them to come and stay all night with her, and so they called home and got permission to do that.
The next morning, Mary Peckham, the neighbor, noticed nobody's up doing any chores, nobody's tending to livestock, anything. She said there's kind of an odd stillness surrounding the house.
Unanswered. She went home and phoned Ross Moore, Joe Moore's older brother. Said there's something wrong at your brother's house, you need to come check it out.
Ross Moore was the first in the house. He had a set of skeleton keys, got one to work in there. Went into the first bedroom, and that's where he found Dinah and Lena.
He immediately walked back out, locked the door, and went and got the town cop. He got to the house, went upstairs, and found the other six victims.
They were all killed with the axe. The family first, the father and mother was killed, and then the kids was all killed.
So it wasn't a hand axe, it was a full-size axe. And it had to be a powerful person to swing and break skulls. It was mean.
And then that's when a lot of the talk came, some rumors, gossip, finger pointing, you know, who could have done this? Who could have done such a savage thing?
And to this day, the mystery of what happened at 323 East 4th Street that June night remains.
Why would somebody kill eight people in a small town almost 100 years ago now?
Never found him. Never found it. No, no, no.
But there's another mystery that draws people to the quaint town of Villisca, a mystery of hauntings and ghosts. Nearly every night as the sun sets, a different group settles into the Moore home, hoping to find the slightest clue or paranormal activity.
Why don't you slam a door, touch one of us or something? You're a big bad man.
You get person after person coming in, ghost hunting, trying to make contact. I mean, it's bound to stir things up, that's for sure.
99 years later, do you believe something happens in this home?